This hike starts out from a lay-by on the Pass of Brander. King Robert the Bruce fought a battle in the Pass of Brander in around 1309.
Well, I'm back in Scotland, about to climb the first two Munro roads of 2023. Just parked up in a lay-by. The plan today is to do then Cruachan and Stob Dàimh. It's really good weather. Tops look clear for now, so we get some cracking views. See how it goes. Kind of on a well-trodden path up this steep bank. Starting to get those views into Loch Awe behind me. So quite a ways to get up to the dam, the Cruachan Dam. A lovely looking tree, some bluebells here. Take a bit of a minute stop, set the views in, lovely views. Loch Awe. Those are the first sightings of the Cruachan Dam with Ben Cruachan behind the pointy mountain, the tallest one. So I don't think I got to the Cruachan Dam by the conventional route. I ended up just following this path. They eventually got me here anyway, so I'll take the conventional way back down. So yeah, the Cruachan Dam. Well, there's the path I should have taken up. I'll be taking that down. So back on proper route, so the one that's most documented. So there's lots of tunnels below Ben Cruachan. There's a hydroelectric power station here.
It has the nickname Hollow Mountain, as the power station is hidden deep within the mountain. In the summer of 2021, the tunnels below Ben Cruachan and the Cruachan Dam area was the film set for the Star Wars Andor series.
It's a pretty imposing dam. Echo! Now we're coming to those steps to get to the dam. Cruachan Reservoir. That's to get me on with the Cruachan Reservoir behind me, outside of me here. Come to the end of the path here. And then there's a quarry that takes us up to the B-Lag, and then up to on to Ben Cruachan. So here's our path. Now we're on this main path. As you see, it's clear tops today so far. But as you probably know, it can all change in a few minutes.
So I've got some nice easy walking to do now on a flattish bit before we hit the corrie for the steep pull up to the Belak. And then it's the climb up onto the Ben Cruachan.
Here's where we take our left and make our way up the corrie.
That's a cracking day for doing some Munro bagging. It's not too warm and it's pretty clear. Doesn't look too easy, but we'll see when we get to the top.
So we're just skirting this mountain stream, it looks. So we're still having nice views on the way up.
So I just had to put my fleece back on. It's getting a bit windy, a bit chilly in that wind. So making my way up this corrie, quite a way to go.
You can see the path before me, that's the steep old pull that was. Usually they are worse than, not as bad as they look, not worse than they look. That would be even terrible.
Just starting a steep climb now. Whew. I'll get your heart rate up a little bit. Breathing a bit hard now. And the worst is still to come. Cracking.
So that's what we've got for climbing.
Well, I'm about halfway up this steep pull to the Belak. It's a bit rocky, chilly, squeaky.
Another last little bit before we get to the Belak. Last pull up. Here's my view from the Belak as I take a little bit of a break before I make my way up to Ben Cruachan. It's just up there, it's about 300 metres to the top in height. So that's Ben Cruachan, so we're just there at the top. See below where we've walked up. So we make our way up. The last bit, the view's opening up into Loch Awe. Still a way to go. Cracking views. A bit hazy, wasn't that? Very clear tops. There's Ben Cruachan top.
Just making that final push to the Ben Cruachan summit. The scrambly bit. Well, it's kind of a scramble.
Finally made it, top of Ben Cruachan. The summit thing's been obliterated.
Here's a 360 view off Ben Cruachan, which means conical hill.
Just there, leaving Ben Cruachan now. Going to make our way over to negotiate the slabs. Still got snow here. Pretty windy. We are coming onto the slabs. See how we can negotiate these. Well, that's this slab's negotiated. That was interesting. We saw a mountain goat just fly up there, and then we tried to find the easiest bit. We got up in one piece. Now we've found a path. Hopefully it gets easier from now. That's where we just dropped off. The native down there. Easy path for now. And some good views of the Cruachan Reservoir. It's pretty cool. Still making our way along this ridge. Looks quite the drop. We've just come off. So there's a bit of snow. Just coming into Munro top, I'll not pronounce it. I've not a clue how to pronounce it, so I'll embarrass myself with it. I'll flash you up on the screen. So it's coming in on the Munro top. I'll try and pronounce it. It's rockade glass. I think it's 1024 metres. Here we are. It's rockade glass. 60 off rockade glass. You can see Ben Cruachan, we just dropped down around towards Oban, and look at it, you can see the nevis in the distance. This is all clear today. So let's go and do our last summit. So on our way to our last Munro, Stob Dàimh. Way up. Now we're second Munro of the day. Stob Dàimh. So we're making our way up to Stob Dàimh. Just up here, looks as though it's got a decent summit cairn on this one. So to get that cracking view, lock up behind me as I'm climbing second Munro, last bit of it, Stob Dàimh. Here we are, second Munro, Stob Dàimh.
Now we're getting 360 views of the summit of Stob Dàimh, which means peak of the stag.
Leaving Stob Dàimh. To the Cruachan Dam. Look at that fabulous view. There's all there, get some footage of him. Probably won't ever be back here. So you can see right across from us where we where I did the climb this morning up to the Belak, that long hard drag. And then you can see Ben Cruachan and to still do about 300 metres of climbing. All good fun.
We're now trying to pick out the best path down to the Cruachan Dam.
It's a free for all down this hill. No real path. Oh, there is. We didn't spot it, and neither did the three people in front of us. We've now picked up a path. Our free-for-all just merged into this path, so hopefully we've got a path now to the Cruachan Dam, and then it's just dropped down to the car. Bit of a stream crossing now. That's where it was earlier, Ben Cruachan, Stob Dàimh. Oh, we're back at the Cruachan Dam now. I'm now about to take the path that I should have taken on the way up, on the way down. Has it really been down there or something? Making our way down this easier path than I took up. I can confirm that the style is no longer rickety. We're getting some bluebells here. We make our way down. So some fabulous views of last views of Loch Awe. We make our way down. Well, we're almost out the woods. You hear the traffic below, you can see the train station just down there. So we're back at the falls of Cruachan station, and run on the underpass. I found out where I went wrong. I followed these steps up without looking where I was going. It's not the first time I've been in the world of my own. So that's two more Munros in the bag. Ben Cruachan, Stob Dàimh, just short of 5,000 feet of ascent. It says 11.5 miles when it was billed as 8.5. I didn't go off pissed that much. I'll have some coronas though later, and maybe some barbecue, get that barbecue going for some burgers.